we have hooked up one of the SKAARHOJ RCPs with Ember Plus now. So this device is connected to your VSM Studio, and we can change a number of things, basically those parameters I was talking about before. And in particular, you want to change memory bank A, because we use memory bank A to set which camera the RCP is communicating to. And we also want to change one of the flags inside, flag number one, because that's associated with telelight on the display. And that would be very useful to have centralized in VSM Studio. So let's just see how this works right away. I have hooked up a screwdriver with the dip switch on the back of the RCP, and we usually use that dip switch to change the camera the RCP is operating up against. So when you look at the RCP from the top, you can see that I can change the camera ID by changing this dip switch around. Okay, so now we are on camera three. And then I want to bring your attention over to the configuration page that I have online. So basically what I have done here is configured my RCP with a single modification. I have added a device core for Ember Plus. So I could actually do this over again if I wanted to. And let's just go load the default configuration here. Then I would say to add Ember Plus support, add device. And then we scroll down to Ember Plus after pressing here, add another device, and then find Ember Plus. There we have it, Ember Plus provider. So it's now an Ember Plus provider, save settings. We go back to the controller configuration, because all we need to do is to enable Ember Plus provider down here so that it is, so you can let VSM Studio connect to it. And secondly, we need to put in the right IP address, the one that VSM Studio knows to connect to. So I've done this now, I save the settings, and then all I would do is basically to update the firmware on the RCP, and it will support Ember Plus. I have done that already, so let's go directly to the demonstration so you can see how we can integrate it with Ember Plus. So if we look at the gadget tree here, we now have connection to the IP address we gave the controller, and we can extend this tree. And let's first go to memory banks. So, I told you that memory bank A was used to store the camera ID we are communicating with, and the value is 3. Okay, so I wonder what happens if I change the value. I'm just going to bring this away. You can see in the gadget tree that as I change the value using the dip switch, it's reflected in the gadget tree in VSM Studio. And likewise, if I used VSM Studio to change this value, and I'll now bring up this slider. So as I pull this slider, just let me just do this again. I pull this slider a little bit. You see how the camera number is changing in the display of the RCP as I pull the slider. Okay, I promised you another thing, that we could also set the red tally in the display. So if I go to system flags, I can change the value of flag number one to true, and it goes red. If I go back to false, it goes white. So there you go. You have centralized management of RCP parameters such as telelight, ID display, camera selection, which camera the RCP talks to, all through VSM Studio and Ember Plus.